everyone, this is TheSighBored here. Right now I'm on the KTM RC 390 and I'll just give you guys one short Motovlog or Motovlog, however way you want to call it. We'll talk about, do you want to be a biker? Very simple question, right? Do you want to be a biker? Yes or no? The end. Nah, I'm just kidding. So, anyway, a lot of you are that obviously are not yet in the biking scene or familiar with the biking scene or what is it like to be a biker, will probably not know that being a biker is not just about knowing how to ride a motorcycle and then you can call yourself a biker. So with that kind of mentality not there, most people will think that, oh, look at those gang of bikers, or look at those weekend riders, or look at that awesome, cool, nice looking superbike. I want to be a biker too. I want to ride a superbike and be like a boss all over the streets. Simple enough, innocent enough. That's a lot of the perception that a lot of people have. But what happens is that a lot of people as well, they see it as a trend. So if you are not aware, right now, recently, in the recent years, superbiking has become the new thing or the trend. Last time it wasn't so popular, there weren't that many superbikes on the roads, but now with more superbikes available, superbike options, the price also is becoming more and more reasonable and competitive. So it gets the interest of more and more people who might not have been interested to be a biker in the first place, are now thinking of being one. It's a good thing and a bad thing, because it's a good thing in a way that, you know, your community grows, the biker community grows. But if not, if it grows too sudden, exponential growth, then it's also not too good, because you'll get a lot of these new guys or new riders that come in, and some of them are rich. So they come in, first bike, maybe a Panigale 1199, and so they think that they are the boss, they are number one, numero uno. But they probably don't have the proper riding skills or attitude towards riding. So that can be a bad thing. And it also gives other bikers in general all around a bad name when you act like a fucking snob. Okay, so that's the not so good part of it. A lot of people as well don't understand that, or they fail to get the concept that riding is dangerous. Riding a motorcycle is dangerous. Don't let anyone tell you that it's not, because they are fucking lying. It's dangerous, no doubt, but as with everything, you need to be the one that minimizes the risk. If you're able to minimize the risk by, you know, having adequate riding gear, having the defensive riding attitude, not riding around like a jackass, then you're probably going to reduce the risk of you getting into a dangerous situation or getting hurt. Sadly, not many people are aware of this or think about this. So once they get the bike or they start riding like crazy, get into a crash, they'll be like, oh shit, this is dangerous and I don't like it anymore, fuck it, I'm quitting biking. Or some that even see the news of some accidents, or shared through WhatsApp of bikers falling or crashing at certain areas, they get spooked about it and they decide that, oh, looks like it's dangerous, I better quit. So these are the things that people don't really take into account when they think about getting onto the bike and being a biker. It's all fun and games, they only focus on the nice part. I get to be cool looking, wearing my leathers, wearing my expensive helmets, my colorful bike with all the racing graphics like the racer. So when you only think about the nice part or the fun part about it and fail to take into consideration the dangerous part of it, then you might end up like that. You know, suddenly, as soon as you get into the biking scene, you're out of it. So yeah, that's the main point that I would like to actually share, touch on. So guys or girls out there, if you're interested to be a biker, I'm not stopping you, don't get me wrong. In fact, I encourage it. But if you think that yeah, I know I shouldn't be doing that, but fuck it. Anyway, they purposely do that to make it hard for you to weave through. Well, fuck you, bitch. Anyways, as I was summing up, I always get interrupted somehow. As I was summing up, if you are interested to be a biker, I would say make sure you check on both sides, take everything into consideration before you actually go on with it. But if after checking on everything and you feel like, hey, that's still acceptable, I know what are the dangers and I know how to counter these dangers to minimize it, I'm still interested, I want to do it, then hell yeah, go for it. So that's all I guess for this vlog. Catch you on the next one, guys. Till then, ride safe, safe ride.